So I am Nilda Bishop, and I am repeating actually a message that I delivered almost 4 years ago in October of 2014 in response to an invitation from Dr. Linda Kaufman to share my feelings about our church in preparation for our annual pledge drive. And this is that same message, what Stevensville United Methodist Church means to me. I imagine that we each have our own personal reasons for attending church, and this church in particular. As I reflect on this for myself, three thoughts stand out. First, this church serves as a sanctuary for me. Here I am safe, for this is holy ground. When I quiet my mind, when I hear the piano or the organ, when I sing with the choir, when I listen to the pastor's message, or when I hear nothing but the sound of my own breathing, I can hear the rush of angels' wings. I see glory on each face. And I know that surely the presence of the Lord is in this place. Here I find peace. What a blessing. Second, this church family fills me when I am spent. We do this for each other here. Many times I come here with fears and insecurities, with wounds, gaping or hidden, with uncertainties and doubts. As I experience the love and support and fellowship of my faith family, I know I will leave here stronger, more resilient, my faith and hope renewed. What a blessing. How humbling. Third, this church, our church, gives me a mission and a purpose. As the body of Christ on earth, we are meant to do as Jesus did, like feeding the hungry, welcoming the outcast, sharing our possessions, offering healing and hope to the lost, and sharing the witness of faith. In other words, we get to share the grace by reflecting the light of Christ in the world to the best of our ability. What a blessing. How humbling. What a challenge. And so this is what it means to me to be a part of Stevensville United Methodist Church. And because I am a part of this church, I get to offer back to the church my prayers, my presence, my gifts, my service, and my witness. What a blessing. How humbling. What a challenge. What a privilege. So are these still my feelings about this church? Absolutely. Is everything the same as it was 4 years ago? No. We go through periods of dissension and confusion. Why does this happen? Because while our Lord is saintly, we are not. We have egos and conflicts. How do we go forward in times of trial? Recently, Tom and I watched the movie 42 on Netflix. Have any of you seen it? It's the story of Jackie Robinson's breakthrough as the first Negro player in the Major League Baseball. One of my favorite lines in this movie is when Brooklyn Dodgers owner Branch Rickey, responding to his skeptical assistant over the wisdom of bringing Robinson up to the team, says, "Robinson's Methodist. I'm Methodist. God's Methodist. We can't go wrong." I like that. Okay, is God Methodist? Sure he is. And he's also Baptist, and Lutheran, and Presbyterian, and Catholic, and he's Pentecostal. And don't forget, he's an Orthodox Jew. So yeah, I'm Methodist, most of you are Methodist, and God, among other things, is Methodist. We can't go wrong. We will heal differences as long as we follow our Savior's commandment to love one another as he has loved us. What a blessing. How humbling. What a challenge. And what a privilege.
Amen.